everybody. Welcome back to another edition of Ellsworth Adhesives Ask the Glue Doctor, the internet's only dedicated expert podcast where we talk about all things adhesive. On behalf of everyone here in our headquarters in Germantown, Wisconsin, and our offices around the world, thanks for taking the time to download our programming. We do appreciate it. I'm your host, Lance Brown, and today our topic is toughened epoxies. What are their applications, and most important, are they right for yours? Now, this is a category of adhesive that we receive quite a number of questions about, so we've brought in Mark Delaforest. Mark is the Engineered Adhesives Manager in the Industrial Adhesives and Tape Division at 3M. Mark, welcome to the program, and let's get started with our questions. First, let me just ask you, what are toughened epoxies, and how are they different from other epoxies?
Toughened epoxies are one of a family of epoxies that we have standard epoxies, flexible epoxies, and the toughened epoxies. And these epoxies have a modifier in the chemistry to help absorb the dynamic forces that are inflicted on the adhesives and the substrate bond line. This modifier is usually a rubber particle or a liquid rubber, which helps absorb the shock, vibration, and other dynamic forces. The absorption of these forces stops the crack propagation, which is usually the form of failure that occurs when the bond line or the adhesive is under high impact of duress or other forces are impacted on it. Standard epoxies, as I mentioned earlier, are the first generation epoxies and are really considered rigid epoxies and have little or no ability to absorb shock and move. The second generation epoxies are flexible epoxies, and they have had an added feature and capability to bend with the bond line a little bit and give under the flexure of the substrates and materials or the application they're involved with. And the third generation of epoxies, the newest family of epoxies, are these toughened epoxies, which I mentioned have a modifier in it that enables them to absorb shock and impact.
Mark, tell us about the new toughened epoxies that 3M is releasing.
3M's releasing four new toughened epoxies into their overall toughened family, 405, 405LH, 420LH, and 920. These four products complement and further broaden the current line of toughened epoxies, which are 420 and 460. 405 is a five-minute toughened epoxy for fast applications where handling, strength, and the ability to move and package the parts occurs within 10 to 15 minutes. 405LH and 420LH are low halogen versions of 405 and 420, and I'll touch on those in a little bit more at a later point in time. 920 is a unique toughened epoxy for oily metal substrates. All four of these products come in the standard dual pack sizes of 37 mil, 200 mil, and 400 mil, as well as bulk sizes in 5-gallon pails and even 55-gallon drums.
How exactly does that 920 oily metal epoxy work on oily metal substrates?
It's a good question. The 920 has the ability to actually absorb and displace oil from the surface or the substrate, and allowing the adhesive to bond directly to that metal instead of the surface oil that's usually on there. It does not have the ability to absorb large amounts of oil, so you wouldn't want to have ounces of oil or significant excess oil on the substrate. That should be removed, and then the 920 can bond through the oily residue or the film that's left on that. As always, testing should be done on the specific substrates and oils that you're using to make sure that the product meets your requirements and the requirements of the application.
Mark, exactly what are the benefits of using 920 versus structural adhesives that you commonly use in oily metal applications and general panel bonding?
920 is a toughened epoxy as compared to most other structural adhesives that are used in panel bonding, which are acrylics. And the 920 has several advantages over structural acrylic adhesives: higher overall shear strength, longer shelf life, broader temperature range, superior solvent resistance, and little to no odor.
Does 3M offer structural acrylics for applications that don't require the performance of 920 epoxy?
Yes, 3M offers a line of structural acrylic adhesives. Our MMA, methyl methacrylate adhesives, are 807, 812, and 825. They are standard general-purpose structural adhesives for panel bonding. 810 is a higher-performing structural acrylic, which reduces odor as compared to the traditional MMAs. It also offers superior strength and the ability to bond to a wide variety of substrates.
Mark, two of the new toughened epoxies that you mentioned are classified as low halogen. What's a low halogen adhesive?
Low halogen halogen products are generally used in the electronics industry and meet a IEC standard 61249-2-21, which is a standard defining low halogen. The standard basically outlines that the total content of halogens needs to be less than 1,500 parts per million combined, and individually 900 parts per million for chlorine or bromine.
Mark, what benefits does 405 offer over 5-minute epoxies?
Most general 5-minute epoxies are what we call standard or rigid epoxies. 405 is a toughened epoxy which has higher impact resistance and ability to absorb the shock and stress at a superior level over the standard rigid 5-minute epoxies that are in industry. Standard epoxies will fracture and break at the bond line when impact or stresses are inflicted on them, and the 405 as a toughened product has a superior benefit there.
Well, what market segments and applications are targets for these new toughened epoxies?
Great question. The 405 is a fast toughened epoxy and is perfect for repair operations on sporting goods such as golf clubs or field applications where a high-strength fast epoxy is needed. It also can be used in production operations where the 10 to 15-minute handling strength is essential to maintain production speeds. The 405LH and the 420LH, as indicated, are low halogen and have an electronic focus where the low halogen content is required. Reducing halogen content in adhesive for electronics reduces the likelihood of corrosion on the circuitry and the parts in the electronic application. Also, other industries that may be interested in low halogen are the metal furniture industry, commercial kitchen equipment, and furniture where it could be used in hospitals or other public buildings and government buildings where they are looking for greener products and products that are more environmental friendly. The 920 product is for oily metal surfaces. It's found in a broad range of panel bonding such as semi-trailers, metal doors, elevators, agricultural equipment, signage, and similar applications.
Mark, last question. Can you summarize the benefits of these new toughened epoxies?
Sure can. The 405 epoxy combines toughened properties with a 5-minute work life and 10 to 15-minute handling strength, creating a differentiating, fast, impact-resistant, high-performance adhesive. The 405LH epoxy combines that same toughened properties, again with the 5-minute work life and 10 to 15-minute handling strength, creating a fast, impact-resistance, high-performance adhesive with the added value of meeting the IEC standard for low halogen content, which is defined as less than 1,500 parts per million. 420LH has a performance and proven reliability of DP420 with the added value of meeting the IEC standard for low halogen content, again defining low halogen as less than 1,500 parts per million. The 920 is a toughened epoxy for oily metal surfaces with advantages over acrylics in overall strength, environmental resistance, solvent resistance, shelf life, and odor.
All right, Mark. Well, thanks for calling in and giving us all the information we needed on toughened epoxies. Good show.
Thanks, Lance, for doing this. Really appreciate it.
And that wraps up another edition of Ask the Glue Doctor. As always, thanks for taking the time out of your day to download this program. We do appreciate it. If you have any questions about the 3M products mentioned during today's program, be sure to visit Ellsworth.com, and you can chat live with one of our Glue Doctor technical support specialists, or you can get in touch with one of our engineered sales reps. You can also reach us at 877-454-9224. If you enjoyed today's podcast, be sure to check out our other programs on our website's Glue Doctor University. You can also subscribe to our podcasts on iTunes. Just search for Ask the Glue Doctor, and we'll keep you posted when new programs are added. Our programs are also offered on Ellsworth Adhesives YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube, search for Ellsworth Adhesives, and you'll find us. Thanks again for joining us today. We'll talk to you real soon. Take care.